What's up, everybody? It's your boy, the Tatermeister here, with an Amphibia review. Yes, I know. Finally, another review. It's going to be really quick because, first of all, I want to keep watching the show. I'm on season 2 right now, watching it through internet stuff. And my gosh, I am super invested in this show. Okay, a little backstory though. I was really doubting this show for a long time, because after Star Wars Forces of Evil ended, I was kind of like... When Amphibia was first announced, when the theme song came out and it was announced, I was kind of like, what the hell is this? Like, for a while, I was kind of like, what? It just didn't really seem like something appealing. But I finally caved in when I met this girl called Fishy, who I'm gonna... Thank you very much for recommending me this show. She talked about Sasha a lot, and how much she loved Sasha in the show. So I was like... Who's the antagonist? So I'm like, you know what? Fine. I'm going to give this show a shot, finally. People have been talking about it forever. The fandom been telling me that it's great. I just pushed them to the side and said, it's not that great. What are you talking about? It's a stupid show about frogs talking and a random girl going on adventures with these stupid frogs. That's what I was thinking the whole time. I'm like, well, what does this show have to offer that really would get me invested? Well, I'm a fucking dumbass. The show's freaking amazing. I mean, wow. This is gonna be a non-spoiler review. I just want you guys to experience Amphibia, because it's a once-in-a-lifetime experience. And season 2 is even better, but season 2 is not done yet. It's still airing, but season 1 of Amphibia is quite truly a piece of art. Like, that's basically the best way I can describe it. I mean, it's not as good as Hilda and Avatar: The Last Airbender. This is certainly one of the best cartoons of all time. I mean, just after one season. The animation, the story, the characters, the arcs, the writing, the comedy. It's all great. I mean, Amphibia is just a show for everybody. It's a show that really delves deep into, you know, good messages, good vibes. It's a show you can constantly rewatch if you want to feel better. And it just has a lot going for it. But before... I just need to talk about my main lady here, Anne. Yes, the one and only Anne Boucherie, the main character of Amphibia. She's pretty much one of the best characters of all time, I mean, I'm being honest. And it only adds to the fact that one of my favorite actresses in the world, Brenda Song, voices her, who, if you didn't know, plays Lyndon Tipton in Sweet Life of Zack and Cody. So her coming back to voice Anne was pretty freaking cool. I already knew she was voicing her. It's one of the main reasons of the appeal of the show. But even without her voicing her, I think this show is so great. I mean, and it's not just Anne. You got Sprig. You got Sasha. You got Hop Pop. You got all these wonderful characters. Wally. You got fucking Captain Grime, voiced by the illustrious Troy Baker, of all people. I mean, you just got so many things going for this show. I mean, Matt and the team really put a lot of effort and passion into everything they do with this show. I'm honestly impressed. And the finale of season 1, Reunion, is a fucking masterpiece.
Sasha! Gotcha! I've got you, Sash! You've gotta be okay!
I think that's everyone!
Anne! Can't hold on much longer! I got you!
Hold on, kiddo!
Hey, look at me! Look at me! Everything's gonna be totally fine! Just hang on!
We got you, Anne! No matter what!
Guys? I think we have a situation!
Hey, Anne? Maybe you're better off without me.
Somebody to lean on.
No!
In fact, Reunion was so good, I rewatched it as soon as it was done. I mean, that's how good the finale was. If something's that good, I rewatch it instantly after it's done. You know, you did a great job. Reunion is just, honestly, and season 2 just has phenomenal. I'll get to season 2 later, but season 2 is even better. Somehow it's better, but. Amphibia is just phenomenal. I mean, there's just barely a flaw I can find. If I can come up with a flaw, I can guess season 1's a little fast-paced. There's a lot of character building. There's not much going on in season one, I guess. It's mostly, you know, character building and character explaining and just one-off episodes. That doesn't mean the episodes are bad. It's just a lot of one-offs, which are great to rewatch. It's not a lot of story going on, really, in season one. But that doesn't mean season one's bad. I do think, you know, I'm trying to think of anything else that might be wrong with season one. Okay, for one, we never actually get a lot of... If you don't get... The intro and theme is kind of misleading because there's not a lot of Sprig and Anne interaction. It's a lot of Sprig and plus Polly and Hop Pop in the episodes. So I kind of feel the theme's a little misleading. I don't know if that's a critique or not, but... It doesn't matter. The show's still amazing. But that's like one little nitpick. I just think that's kind of dumb. You put Sprig and Anne as the focus, and they don't really have a lot of time together just by themselves. I don't really get that, but hey, whatever. Other than that, though, I mean, there's just really not much I can critique. I mean, the show just... I fall more in love with this show every day that passes. I mean, this show is just freaking phenomenal. I mean... And it's mainly due to Anne, of course. I mean, Anne's my favorite character, and she's one of my favorite characters of all time now. She's just somebody I relate to a lot. And I know she's like a 13-year-old girl. Why would I relate to a 13-year-old girl? Well, Anne is just very... I don't know. I just... There's something about her. You know, she doesn't care about what people think about her. She sticks up for her friends. And she's just all around amazing. And she carries the whole show. She really is phenomenal. Besides that, though, I mean, this show has a lot of adventure to it. It has a lot of great stakes. It has a lot of mystery around it. And it's just a phenomenally made show. In my opinion, it's better than Gravity Falls. It's almost as good as Hilda. And it's just freaking awesome. I mean, it's... There's really not much I can say other than that, so... I think I've dilly-dallied enough. You get how I feel, so... Amphibia gets... a 9.8 out of 10. Season 1, I should specify. Yeah, season 1 is pretty freaking awesome. Even with the one-offs, even with the... It's just really amazing. I just... Wow. It's hard to believe season 2 is somehow even better. Even though season 2 is only halfway done. But man, this show only gets better. It doesn't even seem to slow down. I mean, it's just... Wow. I don't know what I was doing in my life. I don't know why I hold it off on Amphibia for so long, but you can call me out later, Amphibia fans. It's fine. I deserve it. I was a dumbass. I admit. I've learned the error of my ways. Amphibia is fucking glorious. Amphibia is fucking glorious.
Amphibia is fucking glorious.
It's amazing. Oh, man. But anyway, so that's how I feel. Now that I'm done with this, I'm going to watch Marcy at the gates. So, the Tatumeister is signing out.